Trouble along the Central Florida coast affecting marine life. Researchers at hubbs-seaworld still haven't found a common link in the high numbers of deaths of dolphins and whales. There have been 75 to date, and though that's not a record, it is still high. West 2's Claire Metz reports now the only factor that stands out was our unusually cold winter.
Just last weekend, two dolphins turned up dead in Brevard County's Indian River Lagoon. And here in Volusia County, a pygmy sperm whale had to be euthanized when it stranded in New Smyrna Beach.
To see two up on the shore dead, it's kind of distressing.
Beachgoers were distraught last winter to see the ocean's ambassadors out of their element. Dolphins dead or dying on shore. Creatures that amaze us in the water, instead beached. Between January and May, 40 dolphins died and 10 whales.
We've seen whales, we've seen all kinds of things wash up on the shore, so it's kind of sad. So we're going to collect some samples to try to figure out why the animals died.
But after months of study, researchers at hubbs-seaworld now tell us there is no smoking gun, no common denominator that would lead them to call the deaths an unusual mortality event. It wasn't an algae bloom that sickened the creatures. Some were thin, but not starving. They had various diseases. They've concluded the only possible reason was our frigid winter season. Manatees, birds, and fish went down in big numbers due to cold. Scientists say dolphins and whales were not externally impacted by the weather. But older animals might have weakened when other marine life in the food chain died off. In 2009, 55 animals died, so this year's 75 is certainly an increase. But the folks at hubbs-seaworld say not a dramatic increase. They've seen years where they've had 90, even 100 dolphins and whales strand. In Volusia County, Claire Metz, West 2 News.